اوكي، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. محاضرتنا اليوم اللي هي راح نبلش بالسكند بارت اوف اور ورك اللي هو دي اكستراكشن. اوكي، اللي بيدخلوا حابين يحضروا اهلا وسهلا فيهم يعني، بس انا كنت قاصد يعني ودي المحاضره عشان اسجل لكم اياها واحمل لكم اياها تحميل، بس اللي حاب انه يحضر عادي ما في اي مشكله لمن اراد. اوكي، هي محاضره امبارح، بس الجزء احنا ما نسيت انا اني اسجلها، مشان هيك بدي ارجع اعيدها. الانسه اللي بتحضر معي سلايدات واضحه، كل شيء تمام والصوت كويس؟
اكثر واضح.
انت اب تو يو، بدك تحضري اهلا وسهلا فيك، بس انا عم بحاول اسجلهم، بديش اغير في السيستم، اسجلهم على الباوربوينت، فاللي بده يحضر ما في اي مشكله. اوكي، عادي كانك تحضري محاضره، بدك تسالي ساليني ابدا، تمام، اهلا وسهلا فيك، بالعكس كويس وجودك بتسليني يعني، بحس اني عم بحكي مع حدا مش عم بحكي لحالي، مش تسجيل المحاضره. اوكي، السكند بارت اللي هو راح يكون الاكستراكشن. بليز نوت Starting from this part, you have to understand, okay, not all what we will discuss here is written, okay, so you have to follow me in order to understand what we are going to discuss. Our aim here is to start to tell you all the information necessary for you to start studying any plant material or nutraceuticals in general, from the plant to the drug. This is the way which we are aiming to follow. In the first part we finished, we concentrate more on the first part, the pharmacological activity. It is very important to understand the nature of the drugs that you are dealing with it before starting the second stage or the second step, the manufacturing, the quality control. Generally speaking, keep your mind that you are working in three different levels. The first level, as in a pharmaceutical industry, where it is your work to formulate, to extract before, and then to formulate the plant in its final or finished dosage form. Or you are working in research institute, زي ما تشتغل زي شغلنا يعني احنا, in research. Or the third part, you are working in authority, and you have to control the finished product. Wherever you work, the same information needed in all of these three levels. So usually how to start? The first thing that in order to understand any plant, we have to follow the following steps. First of all, in the selection and collection of the plant, the preparation of the plant. Preparation means وهلا راح نشوفه with more details, but the time being the identity of the plant. I think we explain this. The removal of the dust, of the sand, of any contamination from the plant. This is called drying of the plant. All of these are called what? Preparation of the plant. These steps, which usually we are doing before extraction. So I have to prepare my plant from identity of the plant, before the identity of the plant, the selection of the plant. Why you select this plant, not the other plant, for example, and the other steps as we will see. The second one is the extraction, and here we have many factors which affect how you extract the plant. The extraction followed by separation, and then isolation of the active constituent, identification of their nature. Here, again and again, the first step, the selection of the plant, as I told you before. What we mean by preparation of the plant? Preparation means that we never deal with the fresh plant. Always we are dealing with dried plants. So first of all, you have to clean your plant from any dust, any stones. يعني زي ما بتعمل بالبيت اه يعني البقدونس بدك تفرمه بتجيبه بتفرمه ولا من نشفه ونعرف ونسال البياع انه هذا بقدونس ولا كزبره مش هيك فور اكزامبل. فبالتالي انت عملت سيلكشن اوف ذا بلانت ايدنتيفيكيشن اوف ذا بلانت واستعنت بخبير اللي هو البياع اللي باعك اياه. Then you remove the dust and so on. If you want to make use it dry, okay, not flesh, زي الزعتر والنعنع for example, you have to dry it and so on. And then we utilize the plant for extraction as a ground. Okay, finally powdered. We never deal with the plant usually. We never deal with the plant as fresh. So usually we deal with the plant as a dried plant and the ground plant. Okay. Then after that we start with the solvent extraction. هذا كله رح نتعلم ورح ارجع له. What we will have, what we call the crude plant extract. شو يعني؟ لحد هون ولا شيء. حضرتك بدك تعمل شاي. اخذنا الشاي، هاي النبات. في واحد قطف لك الشاي من سريلانكا وقال لك يا انسه، قال لك انه هذا شاي، مش هيك؟ هذا ما غلبتي حالك فيه انت. وهو نشف لك اياه. وهو عمل له باكينج بالباكيت اللي بدك اياه، سواء تي باجز اند اجيتي حضرتك جبتي هون وصلنا لهون وطحن لك اياه ولا جهز لك اياه بالشكل اللي انت بدك اياه. سولفنت اكستراكشن، الشاي اللي بتشربيه شو بنسميه؟ كرود بلانت اكستراكت. This is if we you want to isolate the caffeine from the tea, you have to go for what we call fractionation, further extraction, not only the using of water. So you have to make more than one fraction because you are following one compound. You want to isolate the caffeine from it, from the tea. And this is imply the application of chromatography. With chromatography, you will have the caffeine with co-occurring compound. رح تسمعوني أكررها كثير الكلمة co-occurring compound. Other components. Does the tea containing only the caffeine? No. It containing other co-occurring compounds. And the purification of your compound is not easy. بالتالي because of this we called it crude compound, not 100% pure, contaminated with other components. Further purification will give you the caffeine alone pure. طب شو عرفك انه this is caffeine what you want? نعمل here, we are going to the spectroscopy for structural determination. It is long step as you see, not easy work, but this is what is happening. This is what is happening, to start from the plant, to isolate the active constituent, to purificate it, and لسه في عندنا طبعا اللي هو to formulate it and to do clinical study. Because of this, usually a PhD student needs from 3 to 4 years working just on one plant, to start from the plant to the active material. How we prepare the plant? اللي هي الفيرست ستيب plant selection. زي ما حكيت لكم I will come back. مش هيك؟ ارجع اشرحهم. يعني انت بتنام بالليل and you dream اني انا والله بدي اشتغل على النبات اكس بتقوم تشتغل عليه. Or there is some criteria. Yes, there are many criteria for this approach. The first criteria or the first approach is called random selection. Yes, زي ما حكينا بتنام بالليل وبتصحى او بتحب او بتروح بتكون بتزور لك محل بيعجبك نبات and so on. Usually this is without scientific support. Without scientific support, so it is not recommended. The second one is the ethnopharmacology. The ethnopharmacology, okay, in which in the ethnopharmacology, شرحناها more than one time. Okay, and usually one of the big discoveries of the secondary metabolites of the herbal products based on the ethnopharmacology. You remember the story of the vincristine, vinblastine. You remember the story of rizerbine. You remember the story of calabar beans, from which the physostigmine has been isolated. Most of the anti-cancer which are found in the market, كلياتهم based on the ethnopharmacology. So the biggest school approach for the discovery of herbal drugs or plant selection is ethnopharmacology. زي عندنا يعني لما تيجي تحكي والله بدي اشتغل فور اكزامبل على الميرامية مش هيك؟ based on what? ethnopharmacology. كل الناس بالاردن بيحكوا انه الميرامية good for the spasm and so on. It work as antispasmodic and so on. So based on this information, you will take this plant and continue studying it, etc., etc. This is what ethnopharmacological approach. Other approach is chemotaxonomy. Look at the word, please. Chemo from chemistry, taxonomy from taxonomy. So I will correlate the taxonomy with the chemistry. It is well known that the Solanaceae family containing alkaloid. Solanaceae family, taxonomy, alkaloid, chemistry. So I will take members of the family of the Solanaceae, guided by their chemistry, the alkaloid, to discover the new alkaloid from this family. This is called what? Chemotaxonomy. When they discover the taxol, as you remember, taxol came from a tree called Taxus brevifolia. And I told you before that one of the biggest problem of the taxol in the Taxus brevifolia that the concentration is very low. The tree must be 100 years of old to find good amount of taxol. Sorry. And the taxol is found in the bark of the plant, which means that after 100 years, that the plant old, we have to cut the plant in order to take good amount, and we have to wait another 100 year in order to resolve this problem. Very problematic. So based on chemotaxonomy approach, we study all the genus of taxus and the species of the brevifolia, guided by what? By the taxon. Looking for what? For the taxon. This is called what? Chemotaxonomy, and it is one of the important approaches. Geographical approach, we take any area and we study the plant there. ما في أي مشكلة. Computer-based selection method, this is a new approach, which is called in silico. In silico. Now, whatever the method you want to select your plant, أي واحدة منهم, سواء random ولا ethnopharmacology ولا chemotaxonomy ولا geographical and so on, you are not sure that the plant will give you positive result. صح؟ شو بعرفني انا؟ انا بعرف وشفتوا انتوا اكزامبل بال مدغاسكر فينكاروزا مش هيك؟ انه احنا كنا اخذني له على السكري بس ما طلع فيه سكر، ما طلع فيه يعني السكر. هلا فورشنتلي انه طلع فيه فينكريستين فينبلاستين، بس لو ما في these compounds كان كل التجربه ايش؟ رسمت مش هيك؟ ما زبطت، ما في نيجاتيف ريزلت. Now recently in silico a new method has been launched in the market. We know in vitro animal, in vivo in vitro sorry laboratory, in vivo animal and clinical study. Recently, this terminology have been launched in the market, in which I can design the receptor of any drug in our body in the computer by utilization of the computer, and I bring many drugs which are known or new isolated or whatever, and we throughput them above or over this receptor. Some of these drugs will attach to the receptor اللي برتبط فيه, and others not. يعني this is the receptor هيك شكله, and this is they will not attach. Some of For example, suppose that I throughput 100, one or two will attach to the receptor. I will follow these two compounds. So the computer-based selection method is based on this. Now, this compound, okay, which I have an idea that it will attach to the receptor, I will go back to the plant and select the plant which is used for this. مثلا كان سهل عليكم لنفرض هذا الدواء اللي ركب على الريسبتر هو سايمون لقطته وعرفت انا عارفه انا اللي حاطه is thymol معناته انا برجع على مين؟ على الثايم. افرض this drug is reservin معناته برجع بدرس مين؟ the plant which is this compound belong to اللي هو the Rauwolfia and so on. This is called in silico. معناته صار عندنا in vitro, in vivo and recently what? In silico. But keep in mind, I will open two brackets and tell you that you theoretically you will imagine that wow, this is very important thing and it resolves all of our problems. No need for the other measures. Unfortunately, no, it is not always the case as you imagine. We are not always succeed. Unfortunately, on the contrary, rarely till now we succeeded for drug discovery from this approach. The last one is the collection of the literature, information, technique to correlate the biological activity of these compounds. And this is a very important and known approach. After the plant selection, we will go for the collection of the plant, collection from the field, based on many approaches. Either it is called, they are called ecological strategy or ethnomedicinal strategy, environmental, taxonomical strategy, or random strategy. This is for the collection of the plant after the identification and the selection of these plants. احنا عادة يعني usually here we are going for the second approach اللي هو ethnomedicinal strategy. Ethnomedicinal based on their use. But we can utilize any of these. تبعون البوتاني for example, the plant botanist, they are going for the collection with the taxonomical strategy. Bilherbariums and so on, they are going usually with ecological strategy for the plant. So our information, زي ما حكيت لكم, based in ethnomedical information, the plant, رحنا انا وياك وقالوا لنا والله انه this plant is used for the treatment of diabetes, of cancer and so on. معناته based of information ethnomedical candidate plant species, ممكن يكون واحد ممكن يكون more than one of them. This is again انا عمالني بعمل re-summarizing of the results. Plant authentication by taxonomy, by direct comparison with the herbarium. حكينا هذا الكلام before. If you want to make propagation of the plant, يزرعوا أو ما يزرعوا, this is other thing. Identification of the plant with the help of pharmacognosy, morphological feature, as you did in the lab. A quality assessment of raw material. Suppose إني أنا ما اشتغلت بالبلانت, جتني مباشرة إيش the plant material, you can go for this. أنت فاهم هلا, I hope. وبعتقد او انه مباشره quality assessment of the raw material. اوكي. usually we have pre-harvest and post-harvest. Pre-harvest هذا للمزارعين. Post-harvesting after collection it will reach your lab. So you have to be sure that it is your plant, botany or taxonomy. To take a sample under the microscope to examine the key elements, pharmacognosy, and to examine the presence or absence of the active principle, file quality control. This is of the quality control. Is it pass or not? Yes, بيجي من عندك الجواب. It is pass. هو النبات اللي بدنا اياه وفي الاكتف constituent ونوت adulterated. Adulteration ما تهوش, راح تسمع الكلمه هاي كثير, and so on. يلا خلينا نبلش بالاكستراكشن اند سيبريشن. لاحظوا after each step of extraction, I will do bioassay. And because of this, it is called biologically guided fractionation. Biologically guided fractionation. This bioassay, either it is in vitro or in vivo. Further fractionation between different solvents. هذا اللي راح نتعلمه كمان شوي. عملنا isolation of the active constituent. Okay. And it will go for product formulation, whatever the formula is, or product development. خلاص هون دخلنا بمرحلة advanced بالتصنيع حتى نوصل طبعا انه to put this plant on the shelf of our pharmacy. The shelf of our pharmacy in any زي ما النيوتراسيتيكالز اللي شفتوهم. Well, this is could be at more than one level. Even it is one single hair. يعني your formula containing only one single hair. زي ما شوفنا مثلاً ب black cohosh. Okay, one single compound hair. أو ممكن يكون formulated hairs more than one at the same time. طبعاً as your product. As your finished active constituents containing formulated herbs more than one, أكيد راح يصير هون more complicated the quality control and the manufacturing rather than single herb. عندي والله الشاي تي عملت له extraction. Okay, here biologically directed fractionated and isolation. Okay, the active principle. Okay. ووصلنا ل new medicine. While when you have more than one compound, more than one active constituent, the quality control here become more complicated. Generally speaking, من كل اللي شفناه هون, the quality control either it is single herbal product, formulated herbs more than one plant, either it is in a raw material or finished product, either you are going to control the finished product at the end or you are going to manufacture it. As you see, the steps, they are the same. The steps are what? Are always the same. So start wherever you want, and it is very important to understand all of these steps. Again, these steps in details start with plant collection, and before collection, selection. أول step زي ما حكينا, you select the plant. Okay. Keep this in mind when you select the plant. The plant must be healthy. Okay, not attacked by any insect, virus, because the question is, does this will affect the secondary metabolites in this in the plant? The answer is yes. Variation in the collection, site altitude, plant age, climate, and soil. And this is the importance of the quality control. And each time I have a new lot, a new batch of the plant material, I have to control them. So if I change the source, يعني مرة جبته من إربد, مرة جبته من السلط, مرة جبته من العقبة, مرة جبته من الهند, مرة جبته من دمشق, مرة جبته من القاهرة. Does this variation of source, climate, plant age, altitude, geographical, precipitate, will affect the secondary metabolite concentration? Yes or no? Sure. The part used always must be the same. خلاص خلصنا منها, بعتقد شرحناها more than one time, and now we select the plant always from the same source, the same quality. This is very important. طب انت suppose هيك, تخيل حالك, غمض عيونك, تخيل حالك انك بتشتغل بمصنع. طب انا وين دوري؟ اجتني البلانت الرو ماتيريال. They are not according to the SOPs. مش خلاص وقف. Reject. انتهينا. We have no luxury of time, luxury of money, luxury of effort to continue. That's all. يعني at the end of the day, your role is very important in the quality control, either to accept the sample or reject. As you reject it earlier, this means that no complication, ما راح نصرف عليها later on time and so on, لأن at the end we'll finish the product, you will reject it. وبالتالي this is very important. معناته خلصنا. From the first step, إجاني منك موقع إنه pass. Okay, خلاص مسموح له. It is good. Okay, so it will go for the second step, اللي هي the preparation for the extraction. The particle size of the plant material is very important. هلا في كثير دراسات بتشير إنه كل ما كان the particle size of the plant material uniform, okay, قريب لبعضه البعض, كل ما كانت efficacy of the extraction and efficacy of the drug, okay, وكل ما كان أصغر. Now what is the technology of the nano? إيش عن إيش بنحكي إحنا؟ إذا in the drugs, كل ما كان اللي هو the final result, okay. Is better shredding, grinding, sieving. All of these are processes which are important process before the extraction. Before the extraction. معناته هلا بلش راح ندخل على الاكستراكشن. After we finished the preliminary steps, خلينا نسميهم. Then the second step, fractionation, mainly by chromatography. Isolation, structure elucidation, and assay and biological testing. بعرف أنا إنه أي واحد منكم تبع معي أو راح تشوف بالمحاضرة إنه this is a long step, we need year and needs money, and this is yes, this is the workflow. لو اشتغلت زي ما بدك بدك تطلع على هذا الworkflow أو تطلع على هذا الworkflow, all of them will give you the same result. We are working in drug development, drug. Discovery, and during this process, okay, during this process we need many techniques to be adopted or to be utilized حتى نوصل from the plant to the active plant extract. شو يعني active plant extract? The extract which containing the active principle which is responsible for activity. Now the active plant extract or active plant material, depending on what you are using, will go for each step bioassay separation حتى نوصل للليد دراج اللي هو الفينيشد دراج الفينيشد كومباوند at the end of the day. Now the question is, do I have each time to deal before going to the extraction to deal or to reach the pure active constituent? إذا بتتذكر أنت من homework اللي عملته بعضكم مثلا كان يحط ريزيربين سوري ريزفيراترول وبعض المنتجات الأخرى اللي هي grape seed extract صح؟ So depending on your target you will decide. Okay, you will decide. Do you want to reach clinical trials here, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, and so on. This is full work, or no, you will end up at any of these steps. Both of them are pharmacopeian. Both of them are acceptable. وبالتالي زي ما بدك يعني you decide as a pharmacist up to where you are going. You are going, and each steps of these are acceptable. Okay. خلاص اخترنا النبات, عملنا له selection, شلنا منه the stones و sands and whatever you want. Let us take or go for the extraction process. What is extraction in general? Keep in mind. Extraction is very important step, very critical step or process during the manufacturing, because if we understand the extract, all the other steps will become easier. Generally speaking, as your extraction is efficient, not so complicated, okay, this will make your life later on easier, and vice versa is true. And because of this, usually you will hear from me that we want the extract, either crude extract, or purified extract, less complicated. This will make your life later on easier, and vice versa is true. يعني instead of making an extract which containing 10 different products, هلا راح تشوف what I mean by that. I made the same extract but which containing 5 compounds. The second one is better than the first one. 3 components. The last one is better than the second one and the first one and the, so forth. So the extract is a process in which we aim at a separation of a substance from a matrix. كما مر على مثال الشاي. What you are looking in the tea? You are looking for what? Caffeine and other flavonoids. Mainly you are looking for caffeine. وبالتالي when you utilize the water, okay, to extract the active principle from the matrix اللي هو the tea, by a process اللي هي boiling in this case, this is called extraction of the process, which help to release the amount of the plant. So usually in any process we have biomass. Biomass from any source, plant, animal, okay, this biomass will be susceptible for the extraction, okay, to isolate اللي هو زي ما شفنا كرود اكستراكت. هاي الشاي تبعك وقفت انت هون كرود اكستراكت. طيب لا في واحد شطور بده يكمل بده يعزل مين فرذر من التي، يعني ما بده يوقف عند كرود اكستراكت، هو بده فرذر بيوريفايد اكستراكشن. اوكي يوجوالي وي تيك ذيس كرود اكستراكت اند وي ديترماين اتس بيولوجيكال اكتيفيتي. يعني اجتني الانسه وبتقول لي والله يا دكتور هذا النبات بيستخدموه بالاردن لعلاج اكس اند سو اون ديزيز. طيب احنا بكل الستبس اللي شفناها بيفور وي ويل جو اند فولو، وهذا راح يكلفنا 3-4 سنين وماني وتايم اند سو اون، ولا اي كان تيك ا بيج ايديا لايك ذس. ذس از ذا بايوماس نباتك اللي جبتي، عملنا له الاكستراكشن، هلا راح نتعلم هون. اوكي طلع عندي الكرود اكستراكت، رحنا عملنا ايش؟ بيولوجيكال اكتيفيتي. If it gives us good result, positive result, I will continue. If it doesn't give me, I will stop. وضحت؟ I hope انها it is clear. طيب اعطتنا والله positive result، معناته احنا راح نروح على separation, extract fraction. Whenever we hear the word fractions, okay, here we mean the extraction of the biomass utilizing different solvent with different polarity. Fractionation means the utilization of different solvent with different polarity. هلا for the time being هذول بدهم محاضرة كمان شوي لحالهم. يوم نيجي نحكي انه انا I will start utilizing okay hexane, then chloroform, then water. This is a fractionation, three different solvent with different polarity. Least polar hexane, intermediate chloroform, and water is polar. This is what we mean. And I take each one of these three fractions because I don't know where is my compound lies, when متخبي, when hidden. وبالتالي I have to test the hexane, the chloroform, and the water. Where I find my compound, I will follow it. Suppose in the chloroform, I withdraw the water and the hexane, and I will follow what? The hexane. واضح clear what is the meaning of fractionation, then isolation. عملنا البيور كومباوند، كمان البيور كومباوند، لاحظوا كل مرة بده ينفحص وينعمل له biological activity. Because of this, طبعا، وراح نوصل طبعا بالاخير ل اللي هو الاكتف ليد كومباوند تو بي فورميليتد ايش تايم. اي هوب ذات ات از كلير. البيوماس as I told you could be plant, microorganism, marine, whatever the source of the natural product. And all of them we deal them with the same process. نفس ما في فرق. وعلى فكرة the quality control at the end راح تلاحظ انه سواء كنا بنشتغل على natural ولا على synthetic نفس steps the same steps بس شوية خصوصية there and here. Okay. خلينا نبلش اللي هي the choice of extraction method, how to extract. Let me come with you back. You want to extract the tea, okay, plant. This is what the plant. Using what? Your solvent. What is your solvent? Water. شايف؟ شايف نعمل الشاي؟ طيب. بس انت بتحط بتحط الشاي بجنب الووتر ولا you need process, you need method for the extraction اللي هو decoction اللي انت بنعملها اللي بتعملها بالبيت هاي اللي بتطبخ يوم تغلي الشاي او تغلي القهوه. This is called what? Decoction. معناته for any process of extraction we have three different factors and all of these factors must be in harmony. The plant material or the biomass اللي هلا سميناها that you want to extract. The proper solvent. Imagine that the active principles which are found in the tea are not able to be extracted by water. كان شربنا الشاي؟ لا ولا كنا شربنا ولا كان عجبنا ما كان طعمه. That this is the meaning of the proper solvent. وراح نتعلم later on how we choose it. طب in between these two we have what? The method, the process, in this case, اللي هو the decoction. You put the plant with the solvent, water in this case, and you boil them. This is what? Process. This is the method you utilize. If any one of these three is invalid, not valid, the process all will be the failed. يعني إذا كانت الميثود تبعتك, it will destroy the compound. It will destroy. لاحظ انت there is big difference when you make coffee or tea. اوكي فكنا من التي باجز هذا احنا بنحكي على التي اللي هو الاوريجينال وان التي باجز هذا بس شغله سريعه مشان انت ماشي بالشارع تشربها لكن الشاي اللي بنعمله بالبيت ديكوكشن القهوه اللي بنعملها بالبيت ديكوكشن. طب يوم يكون في عندك انت بدك تيجي تعمل زعتر ونعناع وميرميه بتروح على وات على انفيوجن other method معناته لاحظ غيرت what اللي هو الميثود لانه تغير مين البلانت وبالتالي this is the meaning why you changed it change the method because you know that the active principle is sensitive to it. Generally speaking when we start studying any plant material طبعا who decide this مين اللي قرر هذا الكلام النيشر of the compounds النيشر if these compounds اللي شايفينها هون بخلف انا كاتب عليها water soluble heat labile or heat sensitive if it is heat labile okay I can use heat زي الشاي والقهوة if it is heat sensitive you couldn't utilize الهيت وبالتالي يعني thermostable you can utilize the heat thermolabile you couldn't utilize the heat زي ما هلا عملت في volatile oil والنعناع والزعتر and so on. Clear? Okay. Now generally speaking we have two methods for the extraction of the material any material any biomass. The first one is called pooling. Pooling means that we extract all the plant material with very strong solvent. It's very strong solvent. As the solvent polarity increase, as the polarity index of the compound, راح نشوفهم كمان شوي هذول. Polarity index increase. This means that your solvent is strong. For the time being, strong solvent like methanol, ethanol, and so on. The strong solvent are able to extract all the compounds, whatever their nature. They are polar or nonpolar or intermediate. So the pooling here, for example, with the methanol, will extract all the active principles. Well, we take this crude extract, the methanolic crude extract, and we test it. زي ما حكينا, biological evaluation. If it is pass, yes, عطاني والله anti-diabetic as you claim, we will continue. If not, no. وبالتالي ما كلفني إلا one extraction. The second approach is called fractionated extraction. It is called what? Fractionated extraction. In which, هلا شرحتها. The fractionated, we will start with weak solvent, nonpolar, then intermediate, okay, intermediate solvent, intermediate, okay, in between, like methylene chloride, like chloroform, okay, and finally we end up with what? With polar solvent. يعني we take the same plant, نفس النبات, we utilize hexane هون, for example, we extract it with the hexane, we take the hexane extract, the residue of the plant, we add the second one اللي هو intermediate solvent chloroform, we re-extract, take the chloroform, المارك, residue of the plant, add the methanol, okay, اللي هو last one, and now you have three different extracts, three different fractionated extracts. What is the difference between the first one and the second one? شو الفرق ما بين البولينج و this. In the pooling extract here, you extract, suppose that your plant containing 10 different compounds, active, 10 different active and inactive. Okay, now all of these compounds in the pooling, they are going to be extracted with what? With the methanol. كلهم اجوا هون. Here, in this case, in the fractionated extraction, you divided these 10 according to their polarity. For nonpolar, we'll go to the hexane. Suppose that we have two nonpolar, five intermediate, and three are what? Are polar. And here you have three different extracts. Hexane, chloroform, and what? And methanol or ethanol. So when you test, take these three and evaluate their biological activity. If this is interactive, get rid of it. Polar is inactive, the polarity here. وبالتالي I will deal with two compounds with two active principles instead of dealing with what? With 10. Are clear? What is the difference between the pooling and fractionated? You couldn't claim that the fractionated is better than the pooling because it is easier. Don't forget, when we start with the pooling one. If the pooling one is positive, give you positive result, we will go then for fractionated extraction. Like, if we start with the fractionated extraction, this means that I have to make what? Three different extraction procedure, three times biological evaluation, three times the effort, three times the price, and so on. Okay, واضح هذا الكلام. وبالتالي, depending on the case, okay, we choose any one of these method of extraction, and this is guided by the nature of the active or the target compound as you see. Well, usually either you are working, you know the bioactive compound, its nature, or you don't know its nature in order to choose the best method for the extraction. هلا زي ما حكينا كمان مرة بالشاي والقهوة, we know the active principle is the كافيين and so on, so they are thermo stable. بينما بالنعناع والزعتر and so on, they thermo. I know what is the nature. In many other plants, I don't know. If you don't know, you have to be careful about the method you extract in order to choose the best method which protect your compound mainly from the heat. Or in many cases, the active principle could be a group of compounds, alkaloids, flavonoids, phenolic compounds. One last thing, you couldn't know. You don't know what is the nature of your compound. All of them will give you the same result. Usually depending on your outcome, what is your final goal? انت شو اللي بدك اياه؟ حكيت لكم بالبدايه انه in many cases we don't have to reach for the finished product, the isolation, because it is costly and it takes a long time. طب, who decide this? You decide. What is the level of purity that you want to reach? وين بدك توصل in order? Do you want to make a biological evaluation, clinical trials, and so on? And keep in mind, I told you before that it is not required. So you decide where to go. Based on this, طبعاً, you have to prepare your material. وتعلمنا كيف. Choice of the solvents. وهلا حكينا على pooling and fractionated extraction. ولا كمان شوي بالمحاضرة الثانية راح نشوف how we choose the solvent. و based on the nature of the active principle, you will choose the extraction method. This is fast to make you to remind you. معناته أول إشي collection of the plant material, drying, because always, as I told you before, we deal with dried plant material. لأن لو كنتوا عندي بالمختبر وموجودين حوالي جايين بالكلية كنا ورجيناكم إنه كيف إحنا بنعمل all of these steps drying وكيف بنعمل selection of the plant وال plant must be healthy as I told you before. Record, we have to write everything. Don't forget the voucher, to keep a voucher specimen in our lab in order not to mistaken the plant material. لأنه أول حكينا أول step اللي هو نعمل plant should be identified مش هيك with authenticated by sample and taxonomy. و voucher specimen should be kept. يعني شو يعني voucher specimen? Small amount of the plant material and you have like this. You have to keep them in the laboratory, your lab and all the information. اللي بعد 1000 سنة الواحد يمكن يجي يلاقي اللي هو all the information regarding this required plant. Whatever the biomass is, نفس الكلام سواء احنا بنحكي على marine product ولا بنحكي على plant. هذا اللي collection card بيسموه. يعني after you collect the plant from wherever the source, في معاه card, خط يعني دفتر, identity, catalog, collection number, number, serial, the name of the plant, شو هو هذا النبات؟ بعد ما رحت على البلانت تاكسونومست وبعد ما رحت على الهرباريوم منين جبته؟ لوكاليتي should be detailed. ليش؟ مع هلا حكينا قبل شوي انه if you change the geographical source you can face a problem. The nature of the active constituent will be changed. The concentration will be changed. Description, habitat, وين منين مجيوب, date, name of collector, مين اللي عمل له, and لاحظين كل المعلومات هاي we keep them with the plant لانه ال identity of the plant is very important not to mistaken later on. طيب بعدين نعمل عادي افرض حالك تشتغل بالبيت مش هيك, drying, collection, grinding, the same story. اللهم بدل ما تشتغل ب a small size here you will wash the plant material, prepare it for extraction, and you have to dry the plant. Always keep in mind, وراح تشوفوا انه راح اعيد هاي الكلمه later on many times, that one of our enemy in this regard is heat. Always. Always the heat is a problem during the drying or the extraction. So never ever we extract any plant material under direct sun or direct heat. وبالتالي usually these are اللي هم إما إنه إحنا بنعمل له drying of the plant material at room temperature, يعني عادي بتفرشه على الغرفة زي ما أمك بتنشف النعناع والزعتر بالبيت. هاي عملية صيدلانية يعني مش أسمه. لكن لاحظ أمك ما بتحطه تحت الشمس, مش هيك؟ بتحطه بغرفة أي غرفة جانبية ما حداش بفوتها, وبنفس الوقت good ventilation and so on. طب إذا كان في عندي more complicated ممكن إني أنا أستخدم ovens, yes, بس ما تتجاوز درجة الحرارة 30. بكثير من الحالات راح نشوف later on إنه after extraction in order, وخصوصا إذا كان في عندي water I need a time, so usually we use the freeze dryer lyophilization. هي موجود المر على الكلية ممكن إنه نشوفه بمختبري, موجود الميثود بعد ما ننشف. Okay, drying, homogenization of the drying, grinding, and so on. بعتقد كل هذه are simple process in which بعد ما نعملها تنشيف كمان نعملها عمليات طحن. وحكينا عنه هذا بالبداية. The particle size must be uniform. Okay, as it is. The same between the particle size of the plant. This will help you to make better extraction. خلاص هلا هيك احنا جهزنا الماتيريال تبعتنا, طحناها جاهزه for what? For the coming step اللي هي the extraction. رح نرجع بالاكستراكشن ونشوف الديفرنت ميثود بالاكستراكشن and how we do it. This is طبعا اكيد known for you why we are doing the drying. Okay, so by this now our plant is ready for the extraction process. Coming, خلاص النبات جاهز. وراح نشوف a different method of extraction. Who decide this the method? انت. Based on what? هلا كنا نحكي اللي هو on the nature of the active principles and the materials. نشوف في المحاضرة القادمة إن شاء الله.
دكتور لو سمحت.
تفضلي.
دكتور يعطيك العافية أول شيء.
الله يعافيك.
دكتور بالنسبة للامتحان شو صار فيه؟ نسبة التصويت كانت 98 كأنه 95 ل 48.
اسمعي خليني أحكي لك. خليني أحكي.